The cost of electric two wheeler, electric three wheeler, electric four wheeler will be equivalent to the petrol cost of the petrol vehicle, and the country will change.
Are you contemplating setting up a public EV charging station in your area and are wondering what are the regulations imposed and incentives provided by the government regarding the same? Well, then you have come to the right place. Welcome back to the Anticlimate YouTube channel. My name is Pratibha Sharma, and today we will talk about the technicalities involved in setting up an electric vehicle charging station, popularly known as EV charging station. Do you know that India has been the world's third largest automobile market in terms of volume of sales, and in the year 2022, the worth of the Indian automobile sector crossed $100 billion. With the growing environmental concerns, there has been a constant effort to shift to the environmentally friendly options, and the same holds true for the transport industry of the country as well, which is also one of the chief contributors to the carbon dioxide and greenhouse gases emissions. Therefore, a shift towards EVs is not just a matter of convenience, but also an imminent need as well to pave the way for a greener and cleaner future. Apart from being an environmentally sustainable option, they are also quite economical as compared to the traditional internal combustion engine automobiles. EVs are also more energy efficient and have a lower operational cost attached to them. Although they do require an initial investment, they tend to offer long-term economic benefits. But before we get into the details, let us have a look at the growth perspective of the EV industry. As per the reports, the EV industry in India has been showing prominent growth, with around 1.2 million EV units sold, and this has led to a rise of positive expectations in terms of an inflow of investment of around $200 billion in this industry by 2030. In fact, the market size is expected to reach $37.68 billion by 2028. That is to say, it will witness a growth of 46.38% between 2023 to 2028. If the industry can maintain this momentum of growth, it has been anticipated that every year around 106 million EVs will be sold by 2023. And to keep up with this pace, India will need a minimum of 1.32 million charging stations by 2030 to meet this demand. If we talk about what is the current state of EV charging in India, then currently India has one charging station for every 135 EVs, which is very low compared to the global average of 6:20. This gap in India can be attributed to various factors such as increased cost of investment, inadequate power grid, etc. Now, in order to encourage the adoption of EVs in India, there is a key requirement of establishing a robust EV charging infrastructure in the country. And so far, the government has been investing in installing public EV charging infrastructure and has taken various initiatives by involving public and private agencies. Since the availability of EV charging stations is the major key component of the entire EV adoption process, the Ministry of Power released a comprehensive plan for setting up of EV charging stations in 2018 to promote the adoption of EVs in India. With these objectives and aims in mind, the following major guidelines have been issued for the businesses or entities who are interested in setting up EV charging stations. The first is, private EV charging stations have been allowed at residential or official spaces, and the same will be facilitated by DISCOMs. Public EV charging stations have been de-licensed, which means any person is now free to set up a public EV charging station, provided he meets the other prescribed technical protocols and norms. The person or business interested in setting up a public EV charging station will be required to apply for connectivity, and the distribution company licensee shall provide these connections on priority. Minimum infrastructural requirements to set up a public EV charging stations have also been informed. That is, each and every public EV charging station is required to meet the following minimum requirements in order to be able to function. First is, each EV charging station must possess an exclusive transformer along with all necessary equipment, 33x11 kV line with the necessary equipment. There must be appropriate civil works. There must be adequate space for charging, entry and exit of the EVs. You must also have an electric kiosk with all charger models installed as per the requirements flashing on your screen right now. You are also allowed to create EV charging hubs and are free to install an additional number of kiosks or chargers in addition to the minimum charges prescribed in the table just shown. You will also be required to join hands and tie up with at least one online NSP, that is the network service providers, so that EV owners can book charging slots online. An additional responsibility has been placed on the EV charging station owners to maintain the protocols as prescribed and share the station data with the concerned DISCOM. A point to be noted here is, these minimum requirements which we just discussed have been prescribed only for public EV charging stations, which means private or residential charging stations need not comply with these. Now, there are certain guidelines relating to the location of the EV charging stations as well. In addition to the guidelines and the minimum requirements that we just discussed, the ministry has also laid down certain guidelines with regard to the density of these EV charging stations, that is the distance between two charging stations. These must be that at least one of the EV charging station in the grid of 3 km by 3 km. There must be one EV charging station at every 25 kilometers on both sides of the road or highway. For long-range EVs or heavy-duty EVs like SUVs, buses, etc., there must be at least one fast charging station at every 100 kilometers, one on each side of the road or highway and within cities. These heavy charging stations are to be established within bus depots, transport nagars, etc. What is also noteworthy is the tariff guidelines for supply of electricity to public EV charging stations. The tariff for electricity supply to these EV charging stations will be determined by the commission concerned. However, the same cannot be above average charge of supply with an addition of 15%. Now, to promote a smooth transition towards the adoption of EVs in India, the Government of India has initiated a slew of incentives and policies, making it profitable to shift towards EVs in India, particularly in the area of EV charging. And one such major scheme is FAME India, that is Hybrid and Electronic Vehicles in India, and Ministry of State of Power, Coal, New and Renewable Energy announced to attain 100% e-mobility by 2030. Currently, from 2019 onwards, the second phase of the FAME scheme is in force with an outlay of 10,000 crore rupees. The following benefits have been introduced into the scheme, which will be flashing on your screen right now. Another notable initiative taken by the government is the NEMMP 2020 program that came into force in 2020 with an aim to introduce 6 to 7 million EVs on the road with an outlay of Rs. 75 crores and with a vision for EV market development. To further incentivize the buyers and to encourage them to buy EVs, the government plans to make the EVs available at a lesser price by reimbursing the price difference directly to the manufacturer. Several other measures have also been taken to promote adoption of EVs in India, such as exemption from the import duty, reduced GST from the slab on EVs in India 12% to 5% and from 18% to 5% on the EV charging stations in India. Another could be the license exemption, waiver of road tax, providing subsidies, etc. So in short, the government has been proactively taking strategic initiatives and investing rigorously in the developing of the EV charging infrastructure in the country to demonstrate its commitment to promoting electronic mobility. Therefore, businesses looking to venture in the EV charging business in India have a unique opportunity to enter this booming industry and profit from this rising market for EVs in India. If you have any doubts or queries regarding the same, reach out to our experts at Enterclimate by calling on the number flashing on your screen. That's all for today. For more such informative content, stay tuned to the channel. Thank you.